Once again, I welcome all the participants. As you know, previously we covered the details in terms of what actually is a NAAC revised accreditation framework. What are the important things to be keep in mind while you're applying for the NAAC revised accreditation framework and the registration process in specific. So now I'll cover each and every step in details. So once your registration is done, the first important step is applying your IIQ. IIQ, the full form stands for Institution Information for Quality Assessment. So what exactly is this IIQ? IIQ simply means we try to ascertain whether the institution, they are eligible to apply for NAAC assessment and accreditation process. That in my previous presentation, I told you the eligibility criteria, the higher education institutions who want to apply for NAAC assessment and accreditation process, two important things are to be fulfilled. One, either two batches should have been graduated or 6 years of existence. Whichever is earlier, such institutions, they are eligible to apply for NAAC assessment and accreditation process. Keeping in mind that other terms and conditions, they keep on fulfilling from time to time, which is not mentioned out here. So again, brainstorming, two batches passed out or 6 years of existence. Any one of these, whichever is earlier, such institutions are eligible to apply for NAAC assessment and accreditation process. Then, previously I covered what are the eligible criteria for the university, for the affiliated colleges which are the part of the universities or the deemed universities or private universities, the constituent units. As already covered in earlier presentation, they have to come along with the universities. They cannot apply independently. And any such colleges or institutions which are not affiliated to any university, that means they are not affiliated to university, that means the programs which are governed or run in their institutions, they are not affiliated to university. However, such professional regulatory councils such as AIU, or they give the equivalence of the degree. That means whatever the courses that has been taught, the programs that are taught as part of a degree program, they are recognized by AIU. Such institutions we call as standalone institutions. So standalone institutions, they can also apply for NAAC assessment and accreditation irrespective if they are affiliated to any universities or they are not recognized by any strategic professional regulatory authority. However, they are recognized by Association of Indian Universities. Then any institutions who would like to make an improvement, as I already told you that you are accredited in 2019, but you are not happy with the grade. And you think that after 1 year, we have made a lot of improvement and we can apply for NAAC and we might get a better grade. So any such institutions who like to make improvement in their grade, they can apply after 1 year from the date of declaration of their result and before 3 years from the date of their declaration of result. But keeping in mind, they fulfill other conditions also. For example, previously when you were accredited before assessment, you were affiliated. Now you have become autonomous. So you cannot apply again as an autonomous. So you have to fulfill the condition of autonomous also. That is 5 years, 6 months. Subsequent cycle, that is cycle two, cycle three, such institutions during the last quarter simply in year means during the expiry, that means the last 6 months of the expiry of the validity period, they have to apply again for NAAC assessment and accreditation process. This already I told you how the registration process goes on. Why I'm repeating again is it's a brainstorming to all of you so that you don't forget it. Please go on to www.naac.gov.in, apply online, apply HA login, new registration. So, but keep in mind while you're applying, please choose your institutions and the ISHA code. For the ISHA code in terms of for colleges, it will start with C. For standalone institution, it will start with S. For university, it will start with U. Autonomous college, it will start with C only. Keep in mind, affiliated autonomous, C. Standalone institutions, S. University, U. Email ID, mobile number, please give of the institution, not any concerned or individual person. While giving answers to this question, are you previously affiliated? Yes or no, please. If you have been accredited, please specify to yes and give the details. And after completion of this registration, an auto-generated email goes, which I told, which will be active for 7 days. Kindly activate within 7 days, or the link would expire. So now, what exactly is the process of IAQA? The process of IAQA, that means first you have to apply for IAQA, that is filling of your IAQA application. Then second important step is CA index for IAQA. Third, you have to submit your IAQA. Fourth is a clarification of IAQA, and last is acceptance or rejection of IAQA. So how is this entire IAQA application process? The first important, if you see out here, we accept the online submission of IAQA around the year. But please keep in mind, if a subsequent cycle, you cannot apply around the year. You have to apply before the completion, that last 6 months of the validity period. Please keep that in mind. First important is you have to fulfill the basic institutional eligibility. The basic institutional eligibility which specifies either two batches passed out or 6 years of existence, whichever is earlier. Affiliation SRA compliance, for example, there are courses or programs such as which are under the manager program, such as you have MBA, PGDM. They are governed under this the AICT. So you have to give the approval, that current academic year approval for all the programs which comes under such statutory regulatory for all the programs which are offered under your institution. Third is HAI academic data inputs. Academic data inputs, very simple terminology. We have questions that we call as metrics. For that, you will be giving responses, responses in terms of numbers or inputs, and you have to provide the supporting documents. Then you have to pay the fees. The fees, that is 25,000 plus GST 18%, that comes to around 29,500. And HAI document verification on the basis of the data inputs, on the basis of documents uploaded, we'll go through it. And if we see that if there are any clarification query to be raised, we'll raise this query, and this query has to be responded within stipulated time. And on the basis of the clarifications given by the HAI, that is higher education institution, the IAQA might be accepted or rejected. If it is accepted, you move on to the next step, that is SSR. However, if it gets rejected, what does it signify? That means, suppose today's date, 22nd, your IAQA gets rejected. That is the first attempt. So within this 1 year, from 22nd of 2021 till 22nd of 2022, that is 1 year, with three attempts, you can apply to NAC with the same fees. That means you have already paid 29,500. You need not to pay any additional fees. One attempt is today's 22nd, 2021. Another two more attempts till 22nd Jan 2022. You can apply for NAC assessment accreditation process for filling up this IAQA. But however, after 1 year or after three attempts, if you are not able to successfully submit your IAQA, you need to apply afresh and you have to pay the requisite fees, that is 25,000 plus GST 18%, if the fees is same that time. So what are the important documents which has to be given while filing your IAQA? First is the latest affiliation letter. That means all the programs which are run in your institutions and which are affiliated to certain universities, an approval from such universities for the current academic year, that so also programs which are mentioned in the IAQA by the institutions, they are part of the university and we have given the approval for this so and so year. Second important is regulatory approval such as SRA, AICT, BCI, MCI, PCI, whatever is applicable, current academic year affiliation. UGC 2F12B, if you are governed under UGC 12B and you have got the recognition by UGC, you have to upload along with the latest general development grant, because if you want to get the reimbursement of the assessment accreditation fees and the logistic fees, you have to provide the latest general development grant plan document by UGC. Later by UGC, if you are a college for potential excellence, you have to give the proof, that is certificate of ISHE. If there are any change in the names, as already told you during the registration process, approvals by the SRA or the universities that the name change has been duly accepted by the university or the SRA, you have to upload your AQR from time to time on your website. AQR is mandatory for the institutions which are applying for subsequent cycle, that is cycle 2, cycle 3, cycle 4, but it's not mandatory for cycle 1 institutions. Self-declaration and undertaking. In the new revised accreditation framework in the NAC website, that is www.nac.gov.in, there is a separate undertaking and self-declaration. Institution have to upload in the same format only. They cannot change, alter, or delete it. So this is actually what I was telling. This is a screenshot of the portal. If you see out here, we have mentioned the name Test College, but the name of the college will appear out here. The ICA ID, if you see, it's here. This ICA ID should be same as it reflects in your ICA certificate as you've enrolled in the ICA. And this was I was telling that entire thing is through online. The first step there is IAQA. You see, prepare IAQA, make payment, submit IAQA, via IAQA clarification, respond to the clarifications, and on the basis of your clarification, acceptance or rejection. If accepted, next step SSR, then DBB, manage assessment, appeal, AQR, report, support help desk, which I was telling you. Any query or any, what you say, doubts you have during the assessment accreditation process or during applying also, you can please raise a query from this support help desk, the guidelines FAQ. So this is the unique HAI portal, how it looks like for the institution. And this is a support help desk, which I was telling, which is also available on online. If you click on this support help desk, this menu will open. The category would be outer high, low. Then your subject, whether it's regarding IAQ, your DBB, SSR, or regarding eligibility criteria, please provide a description. Priority high, low. Any document supporting you want to upload, you can upload it and submit it, and we will try to respond it within 24 hours. So night dedicated help desk already have told you 08023005192/193 NAC help desk @gmail.com. Monday to Friday 9:15 till 5:45. Saturday, Sundays and holidays we are not working, so please keep that in mind. And what are the important things you have to keep in mind during your IAQ clarification stage? First important, keeping in mind the diversity of Indian higher education system. We know that there are so many languages which are spoken in India. We request you to provide an English translated version of the documents in terms of affiliation letter along with the original documents. Please upload the original documents also with the translated version, duly signed by the head of the institution and stamped. Please make it sure that the name of the institution is same in every document. And if there is name change, please upload that document also. For subsequent cycles, institutions, they have to mandatory upload every year AQRs. And while filling your IAQ for subsequent cycles, you have to give the details of the four AQRs. Please ensure HAI website is function. Functioning means when you're giving the links, please make it sure that link is active so that when we are trying to verify the documents, we can cross-check it by going on to your website also. When institution undergoes accreditation for the first time, it is referred to Cycle One for more clarity, and we apply again, irrespective whether validity is over, it will determine a Cycle Two, Cycle Three, Cycle Four. And please keep in mind that during same cycle, suppose in same cycle, that is your cycle one, you are not happy with the grade, you applied again after 1 year for reassessment. So that means within the same cycle, that cycle one, you have applied for reassessment, but again after reassessment, you are not happy, you cannot apply re again for reassessment. So within the same cycle, you cannot be accredited twice. HAI needs to apply again for cycle three and so on. Kindly please ensure while you are filling your IAQ or registration that your correct cycle number is entered while you are registering. This already I have told, institution cannot come again for reassessment in the same cycle. Please upload the ICA certificate, don't upload the DCA format. Details of all the programs such as PG programs, UG programs, PG diploma programs, PG certificate programs all need to be entered while filling your IAQ. And please mention the subject combination in terms of specialization, general degree programs, and honors also. If there is any discrepancy, we will ask a clarification on the basis of your clarification and on the basis of the response given by the HAI. We will accept or reject your IAQ, and if it gets accepted, we'll accept. We'll move on to the next step, that is filling up of SSR. That's all for SSR. IAQ. We'll move on to the next step, that is filling up of your SSR and the details to be keep in mind while you're filling up your SSR. Thank you.